This tutorial will show you how to animate skeletal meshes in Unreal by blending between different preset animations with Matinee. I'll start by showing you the simplest method so you can see why we'd want to blend animations. I'll be using a very simple example in this tutorial with the player character running across a level and coming to a stop. Now in this sequence, you can immediately see why animation blending is necessary. Without it, the transition between each animation is instant and jerky. Now this is a simple skeletal mesh actor, which has been animated in Matinee to go from idle to running, then back to idle. With this type of actor, this is about as detailed as you can get in specifying how animation should be played. In order to use animation blending, there are a couple of things we have to change. First, though, you should make sure you know the very basics of Unreal's animation systems. Let's take a quick look at the types of objects that make up an animated character. You're probably already familiar with skeletal meshes. These are the character models, rigged to a skeleton consisting of a hierarchy of bones. Animations are created by moving those bones. Next is an animation set, or anim set. Anim sets can be applied to different skeletal meshes, so long as they have the same rig. An anim set contains multiple animations, which describe how the mesh's bones should be moved and rotated over time. Finally, we have animation trees, or anim trees. These aren't in the Content Browser Favorites list by default, so I like to add them. Now, I'm not an animation guy, so you'll have to excuse the simple explanation, but an anim tree basically provides controls and constraints for morphing skeletal meshes and blending animations. We're interested in everything that's plugged into the animation input. As we adjust the values on each node, the anim tree blends seamlessly between different states. I want to point out two of these nodes, top half slot and full body slot, which are called slot nodes. Slots allow you to affect only a certain part of the skeleton. For example, you could apply a running animation in the full body slot and a taunting animation in the top half slot, and the character would taunt with his upper body while running with his lower body. However, something like blending from idle to running is a full body animation, so we'll need multiple channels in the full body slot in order to blend between those animations. The default human anim tree that comes with UDK only has one channel in each slot, so we'll have to create a copy and modify it slightly. So let's right-click on Animation Tree Character Human and create a copy. You can save this to a package of your own, but I'm just going to put it in my map file under the name ATCH Human Multi-Channel. Once we have our new anim tree, we can open it up and find the slot nodes. To add a channel, you simply right-click on the node and select Add Input. I'm just going to duplicate this blank node and plug it into the channel we just created. Now we can save our package and start setting up our animation. And I'm going to delete what I have so we can start fresh. Now if you look in the content browser for skeletal meshes, you'll find skeletal character Leandri cathode. I mentioned in the previous example that I was using a regular skeletal mesh. For blending animations in Matinee, you'll want to use a skeletal mesh mat. So let's place that actor in the level and position it. Since we're blending animations, we need to give this actor an anim tree. So find the anim tree that you created earlier, select it, and enter it into the anim tree template in the actor properties. That's under skeletal mesh actor, skeletal mesh component, skeletal mesh component. And since the mesh is going to be moving across the level in the Matinee sequence, we also need to set its physics type to phys interpolating. This is under the movement properties. Once that's done, we can open up Kismet to create our Matinee sequence. I'm going to add a player spawn event so we can play this sequence as soon as we launch the level. And I'm also going to make the Matinee sequence loop. In the Matinee sequence, let's add a new empty group with the skeletal mesh mat selected. In order to animate this mesh, we need to specify an anim set for it to use. So open the content browser and find kAnimHuman_base_male, select it, and add it to the group anim sets list under the group's properties. Now we can add a movement track to the group, since we'll be moving the mesh shortly. In order to queue different animations, we need to add an anim control track. If you set your skeletal mesh's anim tree property correctly, you should be given two slots to choose from. We're going to add a full body slot. Now if we were using the default human anim tree, we wouldn't be able to add any more full body slots, and we'd have a problem. Since we added a second channel to our copy of the anim tree, we're able to add one more track for the full body slot. When you add a key to the anim control track, you're asked to choose an animation from the anim set you specified in the group's properties. I'll go ahead and choose our starting animation, CC Human Male Idle. In the second track, I'll add a keyframe for Run Forward Rifle, and I'll set it to looping. You'll notice that the mesh isn't performing either of the specified animations just yet. Right now it's in the default pose for the anim tree, because the weight assigned to each track is currently at 0. In order to adjust these weights, we need to use the curve editor. If we send both of these tracks to the curve editor, you'll notice that they're both at 0. To add a keyframe to the curve, control-click where you want the key to be placed. Unlike with movement tracks, keyframes in the anim control track are decoupled from the keyframes in that track's curve. That is to say, we can move a curve keyframe left to right without affecting the time at which a track keyframe is placed. The anim control curve will blend between 0 and 1, 0 being the default pose and 1 being the animation specified in the track. When you have multiple tracks, you can blend them so that their weights add up to 1. For example, when both of these tracks are at 0.5, the mesh will be halfway between standing and running. So what I've just showed you is how to blend between animations in Matinee. I'll go ahead and finish the sequence so you can see the difference between this and what I showed you earlier. So, this is not the best keyframing job you've ever seen, but hopefully I got the point across and you learned a thing or two about blending animations in UDK. Thanks for watching.